Let's play a game. How long would it take you to deploy a system that serves customers on two remote servers and nothing else? A system that can use both a local Raspberry Pi but also a remote cloud machine. Let's say you're literally asked to do that right now. How long would it take you to get there? 2, 3, 5 hours? Okay, now what if you need to make a production-grade automation? Zero downtime, deployment, secrets management, CI/CD integration with Git, the whole package. Oh, wait, there's one more rule. No paid services. Pick whatever you want, but you can't pay a monthly subscription. Some of you are already thinking of Kubernetes or K3S, Docker Swarm, which I covered recently. But DHH, the creator of Ruby on Rails, founder and CTO of Basecamp, Hey.com, and 37 Signals, and a known proponent of modern tech do-it-yourself approach, decided he wants something better. But he didn't just want to be on par with other options. He wanted to take those paid services and obliterate them with an open source available to everyone so that you can get yourself a production-ready system in no time. So without further ado, let's talk about Kamal, the open source that takes any application to production with zero spend. So before rushing to the keyboard, how's Kamal different? Imagine going back to the question from before, how long would it take you to deploy a system that serves customers on two remote servers and nothing else, and ending up going with Kubernetes or Docker Swarm. You'd be SSHing into these servers, deciding whether it needs to be a leader or a follower, a control plane or a worker node, then install a bunch of tools and run a set of commands. Well, with Kamal, you don't need any of that. All you need is a raw Ubuntu server with SSH access. That's it. This, by the way, doesn't only simplify things, the options are endless. This means you can have Kamal deploy on your app on multiple different clouds, providers, even your home Raspberry Pi if you want it. This takes all the complexity away, and we're going to do it today. We're going to connect a web application with a remote Redis, two different continents, two different regions. One is going to be on one warehouse hosted by Hostinger, by the way, and the other is going to be on a completely different server running on AWS in the United States, while the main app is sitting in Paris. If you know one thing about DHH, it'll be that he's big on moving away from the cloud and owning your own bare metal servers. Kamal stands with this idea, helping others make the move too. That's why it's open source, officially released by Basecamp, the partially known project management system by his company 37 Signals. Kamal is written in Ruby, another sign of DHH and his preferences. While we're at it, and while often controversial, I highly recommend his blog and thoughts on tech, life, and in this case, infrastructure. Being a Ruby project, you'd want to install Kamal as a gem. Not ideal, in my opinion, but it works. You can install, or more precisely, run without installing it using Docker, but you'd be missing out on features and the ease of sharing SSH keys, so I skip this option here. Once ready, Kamal version shows the latest install, and do note there were major breaking changes with older versions, so this video is going to focus on the new one, just in case you've been using 1.something. My world-famous guestbook application that runs on Redis, sorry, Falky, check the video up here if you're unaware, is going to be our guinea pig. This is what it looks like. You type some text and sign the guestbook that uses Falky to store its entries. To start Kamal on a project and build a boilerplate, run Kamal init. This produces config/deploy.yaml, which will soon be our main focus, but there's also a .kamal with secrets, which you can guess the purpose of, and hooks. Starting with deploy.yaml. You have the standard metadata required for describing an application. To provide the image, I'll build and push it to Docker Hub. The interesting bit starts at the servers, where you list IPs of ready servers to use. This is one of Kamal's selling points. You don't need to prepare anything. All it requires is a bunch of fresh Ubuntu servers with root access. That's it. You don't even have to SSH to any of them, not even once. Kamal will do that for you. Before we dive in further, let me tell you about today's sponsor, Twingate, the smart way to secure your remote access. You know how traditional VPNs are like having a single fortress gate? Once someone's in, they can wander anywhere. Well, Twingate flips this model on its head with zero trust security. Think of it as a modern city where every street requires its own access path, and a guard asks for your ID before you move on. Much safer, right? But here's what's really cool, especially for you developers out there, Twingate now seamlessly integrates with Kubernetes, so instead of bouncing between engineering and IT teams, you can configure secure access right in your YAML files, and it's all part of the regular engineering flow. No context switching needed, setup takes minutes, not days, and work across all of your devices. Plus, you get enterprise-grade security without the enterprise-grade headache. Whether you're managing a remote team or running a complex swarm deployment, Twingate handles the security, heavy lifting, and you can focus on what really matters, building great software. Ready to level up your remote access security? Head over to twingate.com for a free trial and see why thousands of teams trust Twingate with their secure access needs. I'll use my Ubuntu box, but an IP is no way to serve our clients. I want a real domain. Well, here's another great user experience from Kamal. I'll create my own subdomain here with an A record pointing at that IP. Then I tell Kamal to proxy with SSL, which means it'll create and install the certificate on its own using Let's Encrypt. As someone who had to deal with SSL certificates a lot, creating, installing, rotating, including some major outages for expired certificates and even Google deciding to deprecate certificates authorities one sunny morning 8 years ago, I can't praise this feature enough. I'll fix the image path and let Kamal have credentials to build and push it for updates. The Kamal registry password is listed as a secret, which is a great point to explore these. The CLI can help you here find your way through them, or just open .kamal secrets. These can be read from the environment or files or even some helpers to fetch them using an adapter like 1Password, for example. Back to the YAML, Kamal adopted something you normally see on JavaScript package.json files, with aliases for short scripts. So if you need a quick shell on a running container, for example, Kamal shell or whatever alias name you have runs the command for you. The last bit we haven't covered are the hooks. Much like Git, Kamal comes with a bunch of hooks you can utilize to run pre or post different stages of the process like build, deploy, boot, and others. I think that's enough theory for now. Let's get our hands dirty and run Kamal. We start off with a Kamal setup, in this instance, adding -v to up the verbosity. Kamal communicates with the server, installing itself, attempting to run Docker, and installing it if not found. It'll then log in on your behalf to the registry, install its own proxy, and start the container. But we have one major issue. The container can't start because, if you can remember, it uses a cache instance to manage its entries, and if it can't find one, it will fail, as you can see by the Redis connection failures in the logs. So we're going to add an accessory, which is a supporting system in Kamal's terminology. These are databases, cache instances, and other, well, accessories that don't need to join the rolling updates and deployments when you make them. This is how Kamal separates the applications deployed from its supporting systems. So we'll add a cache instance. Naturally, we'll go with Valky latest. Again, more on Valky in the video above. And now we need an IP. So here's the deal. We want to serve the cache server from somewhere. Now, while I can do this from the same server, let's stretch things out and start a new server on AWS this time in a completely different region. Just remember, the rule here is this. You need an Ubuntu or Debian and need to have root. These rules can be bent, but let's not go there right now. Please, please do not do this at home, but for the sake of simplicity, I'll start my server in a public network. I'll also assign a publicly available IP and launch it. If you'd ask what's a better alternative here, that would be Twingate, of course. You'd want to add the Twingate connector as another accessory to Kamal, just like you would in Docker Compose, and make sure it has its environment network access and tokens to run. Then you'd be able to use the Twingate client to get yourself into the private network. But that's for serious deployments. I'm going back to my raw public server, provide the IP and run Kamal setup. And then Kamal accessory boot Redis to make sure Kamal boots the accessory and places it on the target. Redis is up and running. Now let's redirect the guestbook app to hit Redis on the new IP. The deploy YAML file does that at the env section. So Redis endpoint will now be at the Kamal accessory IP with a Redis port. We're all set up, so it's time to run Kamal deploy and find a stupid bug that panics by default because I haven't cleaned up my code after using it for a video covering debugging in Uvim. So go check that video out, but for now, a quick cleanup, another Kamal deploy, and we should be good to go. Okay, everything is completed successfully. This looks good, took 46 seconds, which isn't bad. Kamal audit comes up with some useful system logs. And just because I'm curious, a quick SSH into the server running Docker PS comes up with the Kamal proxy and the guestbook container. But now it's time to check if it's actually deployed and alive. And there we are. A guestbook spanning two different clouds, two different continents with infrastructure set, configured and run from my local machine, and it works flawlessly. But that's not enough, right? What happens when we make changes? Well, I'll change the title, and the rocket emoji to the placeholder string, then Kamal deploy it and let the system gracefully run a smooth rolling update. 46 seconds later and we're up, the new version shows up too and everything works. Kamal gives you the power to set an array of random machines and bundle them together into a cluster. But sometimes you actually do need the flexibility of any node type, complex wirings and other integrations. In this case, you should check out Kubernetes. But how do you know if Kubernetes is the right solution for you? Check this video next to decide what's right for you. Thank you for watching and I'll see you on the next one.